In this video, I'll demonstrate how to edit a LANDFIRE existing vegetation type grid attribute table. I'll be working in ArcGIS 10, but a similar process can be used in other versions of Arc. In this example, I will edit the grid attribute table in two ways. First, I'll edit the table directly, and then I will edit by adding a new field and populating its values. Before you begin editing, consider making a copy of the grid so that you don't accidentally corrupt the original. Editing the table directly is quick and easy if you only have a few minor modifications to make to an existing field. In this example, I'll demonstrate how to modify the existing vegetation type name field by editing it directly. This is something you may want to do if you're crosswalking data from the LANDFIRE map units to a local classification. Here's how it's done. Start by beginning an editing session. From the Customize dropdown, select Toolbars, Editor. From the Editor dropdown, select Start Editing. Now, open the attribute table of the grid you want to edit and simply begin making changes. I'm going to change the EVT names to make them more like cover types. So I simply click in the field and I'm editing information that I don't want out of the field. You could also type directly in this field to make your changes. Now, notice that by changing the names, I've actually given two types the same name, Douglas fir, Western hemlock forest. I do in fact want to combine these types single cover type, and I'll deal with that next when I edit by adding a new field. Once you've made your changes, close the attribute table, and from the editor dropdown, select Save Edits. Then go back to the editor dropdown and select Stop Editing. Now I'm going to go in and redisplay this grid. I'm just going to select EVT name field again. It will update to show the changes I made to the attribute table. And here in the table of contents, you can see that I've effectively changed the EVT name. Now I'll do a second type of editing. This time, I'll add a field to the table that I will populate with new numbers to represent the EVT types. This type of editing is handy if you want to retain the integrity of the original attributes or if you want to use the existing attributes to calculate values in the new field. To add a new field, open the attribute table, and from the Table Options drop-down menu, select Add Field. Type the name of the new field. In this case, I'll call it EVT number. You can change the field type using the drop-down, but for this example, I want an integer field and I don't want to specify precision, so I will leave these defaults as they are. Then click OK. By collapsing the intervening fields, you can see that I've added the new EVT number field. You can start entering values by hand, but if you have many values to enter, it may be more efficient to populate the field using the field calculator. I'll show you both ways. First, to use the field calculator, right-click on your field and select Field Calculator. Now you can type in an expression. Notice that it already has entered the name of your field and the equal sign. So in this case, I'm going to set the EVT number field equal to the value field. So I select value from the list of fields. Then click OK, and the values will automatically update. Now again, I'll collapse these intervening fields so that you can see that the EVT number field now is set to the original value field. Now I want to make one adjustment by hand because I actually want to combine the two Douglas fir hemlock forest types under the same code. So again, I go back to my editor dropdown, I select Start Editing, then I can simply change code 2039 to 2037. That gives both of those forest types the same EVT number. Now, if I want to create a new grid based on the new EVT number field, I will have a unique value for each of the types as I have modified them here.